Today, I'm building a true DIY tape measure. It is mostly 3D printed project, and you can find all the important links, parts, simply everything in the description. It works just like a tape measure. The more you pull, the higher the readings you get. Here are the essential parts, and you need everything except for the M3 inserts. They are optional. You also need a wire rope and M3 set screws. Next are the 3D printed parts. Additionally, there are optional parts, but I recommend to print them. That is the shaft tester and spring winder. Spring winder is a huge time saver. The core of the project is rotary encoder, a part that generates a signal the moment you spin the shaft. You can find more information about the encoder in attached link. There's also code for Arduino to read the value from the encoder. Many different codes exist, but I strongly recommend this one because it works with interrupts. Here is the wiring for the encoder, power supply and the source of the signal, phase A and phase B. Connecting it to the Arduino is straightforward operation. Power is obvious and the phases connect to pins 2 and 3. It works. We are getting readings and the value is in pulses. This encoder generates 4000 pulses per revolution. However, to apply it in my design, I need to connect something to the shaft. The easy solution is a wheel. This would be sufficient, but I want a closed and slightly more sophisticated design. There are actually ready to use solutions called draw wire encoders with inexpensive models costing around 70 bucks. But my brain had that typical intrusive thought. 70 bucks? Hey, I can do it cheaper. Oh, let's be honest, I spend way too much time on it. However, at least you can do it cheaper, thanks to my great sacrifice. If you plan to follow the build, start by printing the shaft tester. Always check for the seam position. The goal is to find a hole that fits nicely, not too tight or not too loose. And once you have the number, you can print the wheel with the correct diameter for the shaft hole. I highly recommend to use PETG filament because I had a hard time tapping threads in PLA. Once I finished cleaning the parts, it was time to set the M3 inserts. The wire rope in the design is abrasive, so I machined a brass guide to protect the 3D printed parts. It looks very nice, but to simplify it, I replaced this part with a brass tube in the final model. I machined it slightly oversized to hot set it in the body. Now it's time to add the encoder. Three screws are all it takes. Next, we can move on to the wheel. I started by tapping M3 threads for the set screws. There are two of them, one for the encoder shaft and the other for the wire rope. By the way, check the position of the seam in the sliced file. It should align with the hole for M3 set screw. Let's test it with the encoder. It runs smoothly. I actually see no runout, which means that there's no wobble movement. If you don't know, runout looks like this. The problem is that it pull and push the wire, introducing error. Instead of normal readings, you would get distorted ones. Now it's time to attach the wire I'm using 0.6 mm stainless steel rope wire. All I need is 1 meter. I made a little eye at one end by crimping an aluminium tube. Next, let's install the spring. I strongly recommend doing this step once the wheel is installed. I'm doing it now to test it, but it can be tricky. You can always wind the spring by hand, but do yourself a favor and print the spring winder as well. It's a simple three-part design that is very useful. It's super easy to use. Secure the spring, rotate the key to wind it, and once it's fully wound, turn the key in the opposite direction, remove the key, and that's it. All you have to do now is to push it into place, and you're done. Thread the wire to the body and secure the end inside a tiny hole in the wheel. And it was this moment when I realized I'm a complete idiot.
I'm retarded?
Because I mirrored the body part when remaking it. So I completely remade the wheel. If you have a hard time fitting the wire rope, a hypodermic needle is a great tool to clean the hole. Align the shaft notch with the M3 set screw. I was personally curious about the runout, so I took a simple measurement and found that there is almost no movement except for the seam here. I'm tightening the set screw to keep the wheel in place. The last part is the lid. There's a little notch to secure the spring. It can be tricky to get it right. But once it clicks, I can start winding the spring. It's important to maintain tension on the wire rope, or else it will get entangled. Let's test the mechanism. It moves smoothly with no rubbing. Cover the hole and it's done. Initially, I was getting negative values, but there's an easy fix. All I need to do is swap the pins. Perfect. However, I want a fancier presentation, so I'm going to use this Nexion display and a cheap knockoff Arduino. It's a good excuse to test my crimping pliers. I know, this is a very hot glue design, but I need it just for this video. I prepared a graphical interface and flashed it into the display. I uploaded the code into the Arduino and plugged in all the connectors. Everything is set, but first I need to translate the pulses into millimeters. I defined a new variable for this. The calculation is simple. I need to divide the circumference of the wheel by the encoder resolution and multiply it by the number of pulses. And I also added more code to allow the Arduino to communicate with the display. Let's test it. Okay, it looks about right. See for yourself. Approximately 80 millimeters. It's not a perfectly precise measurement, but luckily I can use my milling machine with a digital readout to verify it. First, I want to test the repeatability at 100 and 200 millimeters. I'm getting the same values, which is surprisingly good. However, the value from the encoder doesn't correspond to the DRO reading, so I need to readjust the value. Now I'm running a new test along with readings from the DRO. The results are a little bit off, but let's be honest, I did not expect such precision. It's surprisingly accurate. But how much did it cost? For me, it was more than 70 bucks for the prototype. However, every other piece would cost around 30 bucks, including all listed components, the encoder and the PETG filament, all the stuff. And that's it. Thank you for watching, and as always, till next time.